We live in rather strange times, where if a group of activists decide to write an open letter to the Prime Minister protesting against what they see as cow vigilantism and mob lynching, they have a sedition case filed against them in the Bihar police. When a professor forwards a meme of a political leader, he is arrested. When a group of tribals in Jharkhand try to assert their identity, 10,000 of them have sedition filed against them. A law which was used by the colonials to target the likes of Mahatma Gandhi is now in the 150th year of his birth anniversary, virtually a license for whoever is in power to muzzle dissent, to question, to target those who question them. That's what we're going to discuss. We're joined by four very special guests. Agnmitra Paul is BJP leader and fashion designer. Dr. Ashok Kumar Ganguly is former justice at the Supreme Court.
No, I'm not a doctor. Just call me Justice Ganguly.
Ashok Kumar Ganguly.
Yes, that's all.
Is former Supreme Court judge. Syantan Basu is General Secretary of the Bharatiya Janata Party. And Ratnaboli Roy is an activist. And I'm going to start with you, Ratnaboli, because you yourself were among those, that group of 40 to 50 intellectuals, activists, who were charged with sedition by a Muzaffarpur police in an FIR because you wrote an open letter to the Prime Minister targeting cow vigilantism, targeting those who were resorting to mob lynching in the name of cow protection. What did you first think when you heard that you were being charged with sedition for simply being a signatory to a letter that had been written to the Prime Minister?
Well, to be very honest, I was very amused, because a benign letter like that, a very modest letter like that, which was pretty much straightforward, without any subtexts or without any layers, could invoke that kind of charges, amused us. And then, of course, we thought that, well, this is a kind of dhamki, and that's serious. Those were my first thoughts. Yes, it was a dhamki. And it was a dhamki, and I also wondered that if India is a mature democracy that we are, how come that kind of a petition was even admitted in court of law?
Was it a dhamki, or was it simply an overzealous police officer saying, inko sabak sikhana hai?
No, I think it was a dhamki, and later we found out that the British petitioner was a chronic frivolous petitioner who has a history. But what happened to that? Nobody questioned that. We were questioned for our letter, which was pretty straightforward and very modest, urging our Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, to take action against the lynching. And this, and we took the cue from the Prime Minister when he actually said it in the Parliament in the month of June regarding a lynching in Jharkhand, that we must stop it. And that's where we picked it up from. And if we are anxious, if we are anguished, if we can't go to the Prime Minister, who will we go to?
You know, in her case, it's a case where activists write an open letter to the Prime Minister. There's a BJP government in Jharkhand. Here we have a Trinamool Congress government, Agnmitra. You're a BJP activist. You haven't been charged with sedition yet. But do you believe that this is a disease that is spreading across the country, the misuse or use of state power, police officers being more loyal than the king or queen in this case, immediately going ahead and charging people under various offenses or using state power to target anyone who is seen to oppose them?
Very much. I mean, in our state, you know, everybody knows a few years back, there was this Jadavpur professor, Umbikesh Mohapatra Mahashay. He had just, you know, forwarded a cartoon of our Honorable Chief Minister. and she was heckled, jailed, tortured. Very recently, a very, very honorable, you know, journalist, a very dignified journalist of the Congress Party, Mr. Shonmoy Bondopadhyay, he runs a portal called Banglar Barta. He was picked up from his home at 7 p.m. in the evening. He was not allowed to wear his slippers. He was asked to open his shirt. He was pushed and taken to the police station, tortured brutally, and now he's under medical treatment. That was without a warrant. Even with me, you know, when I had gone for a fresher's welcome in Jadavpur University with the Honorable Minister, Mr. Babul Supriyo, we were there for just a fresher's welcome. But the communist students over there, the TMC students over there, they heckled me. They touched me, they tore my sari, and you all saw it on television. And there was not a word of, you know, sympathy or, you know, saying sorry that whatever has happened is wrong from our Honorable CM. And you have been seeing this. Ratnaboli Di and Reena Di Aparna Shen, they had written a letter. I think it's completely fair to write a letter to the Honorable PM. But where are your letters, you know, when Priyanka Reddy gets raped, when our Hindu boys are jailed for uttering Jai Shri Ram? Where were your letters? That was also lynching when our CM used to put them in jail. Where were your letters? Where were your candlelight marches? Where are your candlelight marches when Malda little girl has been raped and murdered? There are no... So there is a very selective secularism in our state. And thank God I'm not part of that group.
Ratnaboli, well, that's like a red rag to a red bull. Are you selective in sending out letters, in writing to the Prime Minister when it comes to lynching? But where are you when there is state power used or misused in Bengal?
Rajdeep, I love Ogni. And Ogni and I go back many years.
I love you too, Didi.
Ha. But the point is...
Rather strange way of expressing Bengali love, but go ahead.
Yeah. But Rajdeep, it is very important to distinguish two things. One is every time we talk about selective outcry, we know in our heart of heart that it's a hollow argument. Because if I'm passionate for people that I work with and for, the large constituency of disabled people, I'm very passionate. I'm very passionate about women. I'm very passionate about whatever happens on minority population. I may not be passionate about other things. So why is it such a big deal and saying that we have to, I mean, it's a citizen's prerogative. I mean, I have a right to choose about what I'm going to protest on and the methodology and the process.
If you protest against the fact that you believe lynching is going unchecked in Jharkhand, a BJP ruled state, should you not protest when political activists are jailed or targeted here in Bengal?
Of course we should protest. It never went unprotested. I think we must do a fact check on that. As far as Ogni's heckling is concerned, I was deeply disturbed by it. And of course I talked about it. But you have to understand that in Bengal, sedition case was not invoked. And it is rather a calibrated kind of repression that we are seeing. And there is a huge difference between calibrated repression and sedition. I mean, let's not fool ourselves.
Okay, Agni, you want to respond to that? And then I'll go to Justice Ganguly in a moment.
No, I respect Ratnaboli Di's work. She does brilliant work. I have seen her work. But, you know, I couldn't understand her logic that, you know, we have discretion of where we want to protest and where we don't want to protest. You want to protest when our Muslim brothers are being lynched, but you want to stay quiet when our Hindu brothers are being lynched.
That's not what I said. Lynching is a lynching, whether it happens in Delhi, whether it happens in Bengal, in Telangana.
But Didi, there are so many of our brothers who got lynched in West Bengal. Why didn't you all send a letter to the PM? Why didn't you send a letter to the Honorable CM? That we don't acknowledge this kind of brutality.
How do you know, Agni, that we
I haven't seen any letter from, like everybody knows.
That is it. We that didn't send an open letter to the PM,
but we don't know that you have sent a letter to
the Honorable CM as well.
Okay, okay.
We did.
Let's do a timeout on the Bengali Love Fest. Let's look at it, Justice Ganguly. From the perspective, the truth is, statistically, sedition cases alone have increased by 45% just since 2017. The most recent, and this doesn't include the most recent case that has come out, of 10,000 tribal activists who were simply trying to assert their identity in a village, all being charged with sedition. This was meant to be a law in exceptional circumstances. It's now being used as confetti against journalists, against activists. Anyone you don't like, you can charge them with sedition.
Yes, this is obviously an abuse. May I just explain to you this concept of sedition a little? I'll take not more than 2-3 minutes. You see, sedition as a charge, as a criminal offense, was introduced in the British, during the British regime. The colonial masters did it for obvious reason to suppress dissent. And you know the famous cases of sedition trial against Tilak and Gandhiji. Gandhiji explained it so well, I feel tempted to quote him. Now, after our independence came, those who fought for our independence, they were also targeted under sedition. They were, when the constitution was drafted, we were given a freedom of speech and expression under Article 19(1)(a). But there are certain exceptions to that. Sedition, whether sedition should be an exception to free speech. Free speech, that was debated in our Constituent Assembly. Mr. Munshi fought against it and sedition was dropped. Now I'll tell you the very, very interesting story of our case. The first decision by the Supreme Court on freedom of speech and expression where sedition has been considered, that is Ramesh Thapa's case. The case came like this. There is a newspaper called Searchlight, which is to be published from Bombay. And it was very critical of Nehru's policies, especially its foreign policies. And at that time, in Madras, which was the western part of Madras, now Kerala, communist movement was gaining ground. And this Searchlight was supportive of that. There was the Madras government, under its public order law, stopped its entry into Madras presidency. That was challenged directly before Supreme Court by the publisher. And the Supreme Court gave a judgment where they discussed sedition, that sedition should not be read into our fundamental right of freedom of speech and expression, because that has been dropped. And there the Supreme Court gave the test that when there was a, in Tilak's case, the test which was employed by the British judge was this, that if you spread disaffection, disloyalty, or hatred against the government, whether it leads to incitement of any offense or violence, even then it is sedition. Disaffection per se is sedition. But then in Niharanda Dutta Mojumdar's case, you might have heard his name, Justice Maurice Garr sort of scaled it down, said mere disaffection is not sedition. It has to be coupled with incitement to an offense. And that was accepted by our Supreme Court also in Kedarnath Banerjee's case.
But Professor Ganguly, while
no,
that...
I'll just give
no, no, but that case history is being...
I'm trying to explain. Is being
challenged by your lower court judges who are openly accepting these cases.
Why are
the judges so willing to accept these cases?
They understand. I tell you what happened in these recent cases against those 49 persons who wrote to the Prime Minister about lynching. A case was initiated against them, but even then the case when it was initiated against them, the police failed to make out a case. The court took it up. The court should have realized that there is no case of sedition. It's a mere pointing out of some thing which is wholly undesirable situation in this state.
So why don't courts, Justice Ganguly, reject these cases ab initio?
The court should
why
not.
Even entertain them?
The court should not. It has been very clearly distinguished in Kedarnath's case by Supreme Court. Unless there is an incitement to violence or disorder. There is no sedition. If I criticize the government, then freedom of speech goes for a toss. So this is the principle of law that the judges should know.
But, you know, is it lack of knowledge of the judges? Are judges playing to the gallery?
Of course, I do not know what the judges do, but certainly lack of knowledge. When Supreme Court had said it very clearly, accepting the Niharidu Dutt Mojumdar, Justice Maurice Geyer's conception of elucidation of sedition. You must know, but despite, I tell you, when this judgment was delivered in Ramesh Thapa's case, the then Home Minister, you can't accuse the BJP only. There it is, he has written it to the Prime Minister Nehru that you must do something to amend this judgment. And then came the amendment of the First Amendment of the Constitution.
You know, let me ask Syantan.
What has happened. And what about the sedition case during Congress regime? Even people like Arundhati Roy, Vinayak Sen, and others. Everywhere when there is party in power, they do not accept criticism.
Is that what it is, Syantan Basu, as a General Secretary of the BJP? The BJP is accused in BJP rules.
I am not a party man, I am saying.
Sure.
Whenever there is a criticism against the government uses this as a weapon, like the Britishers did.
Yeah, but the British have long left us, Syantan Basu. whoever is in power, whether it's the BJP in states where they use sedition, or whether you today accuse the Trinamool Congress of misusing state power, at the end of the day, it boils down to the way you see state power. The police force in particular is an ally of whoever is in power. Governments change, the police force is loyal to whoever is in power. Bengal is a good example of that.
I disagree with your word good example. I would say...
Or a bad example.
I would say that Bengal is the most effective example. Here you are using the word sedition, but I think... you should use the phrase state operation, state machinery operation. My party doesn't believe in all these political vendettas and all these things, or state operation machinery. Whatever happened with the sedition charge in the Jharkhand or in Bihar, as per my knowledge, neither the Bihar police nor the any agency from the central government has taken any action against the so-called accused persons. Has taken any actions.
Syantan, are you aware that Ashish Nandi, one of the country's most celebrated social scientists from this very state of Bengal, was charged with sedition by Narendra Modi's government when Mr. Modi was Chief Minister of Gujarat? Are you aware of that or not?
I can put you 100 examples in my state. We have 19, 18 governments. You can give us 18, 17, 16 examples. But in only one state, Justice Ganguly is in here, is the former judge of Supreme Court. Just for giving a statement against the state government, he has been accused in a false case. He has been victimized. So can you understand the West Bengal government's apathy, policy and their capacity to frame a former Supreme Court judge? And what is happening with the common village level BJP workers? Here you are talking about sedition. Unfortunately, we are talking Chanmay Banerjee's case, Priyanka Sharma, our young BJP lady worker from Howrah. She has just created one meme, just forwarded one meme of Srimati Banerjee, Chief Minister. That picture resembles with one with Priyanka Chopra, film actress. That young lady was put behind bars for 10 days. When Supreme Court gave the judgment that arrest was illegal, our state government asked that lady, you have to give one declaration that you will never do it again, then we can only release you.
Ratnaboli, in cases like this, where were you, where was Aparna Sen is the question that is often asked. We now live in a world of what about?
No, Aparna Sen has not been picked up.
He has not been put behind bars, at least. I am asking the question that why is it that in such cases, in this whataboutry that we exist, what about the case of Priyanka Sharma? Why didn't the so-called left activists or activists in general protest against the Mamata government.
Mr. Sadhusha, I just, please allow me for 1 second. Hear what Mrs. Roy or something was telling, that we can write a letter to the Prime Minister. If they have the guts, if they can write a letter to Chief Minister, they will have the same faith, just like Priyanka Sharma has or like Sanmay Banerjee has. I can assure you very categorically.
Is that true, Ratnaboli, that if you wrote a letter to Mamata Banerjee today protesting against the cases where BJP activists or any activists are targeted in Bengal, or Justice Ganguly is targeted, would you be charged with sedition by Mamata Di?
Well, as I said, that we will not be charged with sedition.
You will not be charged with sedition?
No, because it will be much more calibrated, Rajdeep. It will be much more calibrated.
What does this word calibrated mean?
The repression will come in a very insidious way, and the authority and the power that be are very opaque. That's the problem with TMC. So you don't know how it is going to come. I'll give you an example. Just very recently, a film was withdrawn
yes.
from Bengal. And it was not a film that should have been banned. But it was something that happened because the authority is very opaque and we don't know where the orders came from. So the repression and the authoritarianism, the nature of it is different. But, you know, coming back to Agni and Mr. Basu, I mean, we have to address the issues. We just cannot go on saying that you didn't appear at point X, therefore you don't have the right to appear at point Y and seek justice. Because if we have talked about lynching to Honorable Prime Minister, it is an expectation that both Agni and Mr. Basu would say, yes, we will address the lynching, and not question and say that, Where were you when so forth?
No, we haven't said that.
I said I appreciate.
No, but the fact is, you claimed that when someone in Bengal is targeted, let's say, for Jai Shri Ram slogans, you know, people don't come out and protest or defend that person who's been harassed or targeted or persecuted. The flip side could be, people like you are nowhere to be seen when, let's say, a young Muslim boy is lynched in Jharkhand, because there it doesn't suit your agenda.
Prime Minister has categorically condemned the act. Even he has termed the act as barbaric act.
Yes, I agree. Prime Minister in the month of June did categorically say that it's not acceptable. But what has
happened after that,
Mr. Basu, is something that we need to reflect and introspect and interrogate. It is not about what TMC has done. We are already saying what TMC has not done.
Sure. Let me give one example.
The
politicians will... Just a minute, sir. The politicians will keep blaming each other. And, you know, we can go endlessly with the blame game. I want to know the role of the judiciary. Do you believe the time has come to just remove sedition of the statute books? Why do you need sedition? This was a law that was brought in when the British were in power.
State operation, not sedition. State operation, state machinery operation.
No, 1 minute. At the moment, in our law, Justice Ganguly, and this has been debated, many people like Soli Sorabji believe that the time has come to remove sedition of the statute books. Do you agree?
Yes, I agree. I tell you, what is in no civilized democratic country, sedition is a crime. I tell you, in England, it has been removed. In America, the sedition statutes has expired, they have not been renewed. But what has happened in India is something very, very astounding. Sedition in British India, even in British India, was not a cognizable offence. But by way of an amendment made during Prime Minister Indira Gandhi's time, it has become a cognizable offence. You understand the meaning of a cognizable offence? Where a person can be arrested without a warrant. Even Tilak could not be arrested without a warrant during British India. But Kanhaiya Kumar could be and was arrested without a warrant.
So do you believe Kanhaiya Kumar was someone who should have been arrested?
For this speech in JNU? No, certainly not.
Definitely.
He should have been arrested.
You think
Kanhaiya Kumar should have
been arrested
for the speech he gave?
No.
You're saying no, they're saying yes.
Mr. Sadeshai,
yes.
I do believe that whatever... letter has been written to the Prime Minister. that cannot be caused as a sedition. But yes, Bharat tere hazar tukre honge, inshallah, inshallah, it's a sedition. Ek abjal maroge to hazar abjal nikalenge, it is sedition.
There is a difference between...
Rajdeep, before we come to tukre tukre gang, and since we are talking about the open letter so much, we really cannot not talk about the response to that letter, because that response to that letter, the rejoinder to that letter signed by 61 celebrities, Sonal Mansingh, Kangana Ranaut.
No, Kangana didn't sign your letter.
Anupam Kher, Prashun Joshi, the letter that they wrote, we have to deconstruct that letter. The letter is fascinating. It's a fascinating letter. And there it has become very clear that if we have to be committed to the truth, that truth has to be validated by majority of people. If I say something, if Ogni and Syantan Basu is not agreeing with me, then it is not truth. And that's dangerous.
We are living in dangerous times. Are absolutely agreeing with you. I told you that, you know, I appreciate the letter that you wrote to the,
so the
Honorable
point
PM.
Am,
but
Rajdeep,
my problem is Rajdeep, that my question to you is that you are writing a letter to the PM, but you aren't writing a letter to the CM, or you aren't protesting of what is happening in the state. Why aren't you protesting of what's happening in the state? What are you afraid of? Or what are you thinking of getting some...
May I just say one sentence?
Yes.
What the Honorable CM has done on stage, in public view, a farmer, poor farmer, asked her in a public meeting. She was a supporter of CM. CM's party, Shiladitya Chaudhary, why the price of seeds and other things, fertilizer is going up, and CM's prompt answer, he's a Maoist arrested. CM asking her police to arrest an innocent man, just because raised the question, why the price of, this is the country, our country, this democratically elected leader of this state.
Are you fearful of Mamata Banerjee? Unfortunately, the Trinamool Congress is not representing. Unfortunately,
I'm saying is a fact. I am not fearful of anybody. In an open public meeting, she asked her police to arrest that person because, according to her, he is a Maoist. The police found he is not a Maoist. Even then, he was arrested.
You seem to
It's the same thing in the state. I mean, whatever you do, if you go against the CM,
I'm telling you,
you'll be picked
telling
up.
This has happened in the state.
Or you'll be given
he
a Ganja case.
Just ask the question, why the price is growing up?
I would share a personal anecdote.
Yes.
I think that would sort of calm Ogni down.
No, I'm absolutely at peace.
Okay.
Completely.
So, I thought you were not.
No.
So, in 2013,
let us speak.
11 activists were picked up from in front of Mamata Banerjee's house for peacefully protesting against the Kamduni rape, right? We went to the Lal Bazaar, 13 of us went to the Lal Bazaar, we were there for 7 hours, and we didn't know why we were being hounded and locked up in Lal Bazaar. We didn't know about that. The point is that we have not been afraid, because there is a space for dialoguing, there is a space for debate. And Ogni, I cannot share all the strategies. We have done one open.
You believe that space exists still in Bengal?
Of course, there is a space of dialoguing. But if you look at Prashun Joshi's letter in response to our letter, you will see that definitely the space for dialoguing is not there, because the truth is on the side of the victors.
Isn't it true, in a sense, Syantan, that we are living through competitive intolerance? Your intolerance versus my intolerance. That's the nature of our society. We become them versus us. And whoever is in power then uses state power to use, to in a sense, subdue anyone who goes against us. It could be Mr. Modi at the center. It could be Mamata Di here in Bengal.
Actually, we may have some faults. Our state governments may have committed some faults. But in West Bengal, whatever is in here, it cannot be held. It cannot happen in any civil society. It cannot happen. I am challenging to anyone who are with Mamata Banerjee. If you can, you can go against Mamata Banerjee. You will be treated same like Justice Ashok Ganguly, Sanmay Banerjee, and other persons who are opposing to her. She doesn't believe in democracy. She doesn't believe in civil society's activities. Our main focus was that he was talking about Shiladitya Chaudhary. Can you imagine? Five young boys, they were shouting Jai Shri Ram when Mamata Banerjee, when Chief Minister was going on. He just asked the police, pick them. They are antisocials. They are just shouting at me. Is it democracy? Is it a civil government? Mr. Sardesai, you should have focused on this particular issue. Sedition is a very strange case. It is an exception, whatever you are doing. But in West Bengal, it's a regular thing. It's a common phenomenon here.
Yes, Ratnaboli.
Yeah. I just want to quickly respond.
Syantan and Agni are saying it is state oppression. That's the real issue, not so much sedition, it's state oppression.
I am not going into sedition again. Mm-hmm. But what I am going into is the fact that Jai Shri Ram or Azadi, whatever we chant, we have been chanting. But why Jai Shri Ram has now become a war cry?
Hazar tukre honge, Manipur mange Azadi, Bengal mange Azadi, and Jai Shri Ram are not same. It's sedition.
Mr. Basu, you have to calmly tell me that why has Jai Shri Ram now become a cry? Because we have been chanting Jai Shri Ram, we have been chanting Jai Rahim, we have been chanting Allah.
Why you have the allergy with Jai Shri Ram? Why the Chief Minister has the allergy with Jai Shri Ram?
We have no allergy. I'm asking you a specific question.
Why are you asking? If you don't have any allergy, why are you asking me?
Because Azadi has not become a war cry.
Okay, Agni, I'll give you...
Who have said so?
I'll give you one word and then...
I am telling you. No, it's not.
No, it's untrue. If you go to the debate... Ramayan is there, that's why we held Durga Puja during... During the time,
I am not disputing.
Is that how you debate in a Kolkata coffee adda? Is that how you, you know? You want to let me give you a final word, and then I'll give the judge, Justice Ganguly, a final word. Let's be very clear. Raised tempers of this kind reveal, in a sense, how society is getting more and more polarized. Let's be honest. Isn't it getting polarized? You're also pitching it as Hindu versus Muslim.
Not
Why
at
is
all.
Everything versus each
not
other?
Not at all. I am not saying Hindu versus Muslim. What you I wanted to say is that if you are protesting, you should protest for everything what is wrong, what is happening in the state. You can't be selectively protesting for one thing which is against the central government.
Will you go and afraid
of the CM and you will not protest.
So will you go and protest in Jharkhand?
Government. That is what I am protesting.
When your police fails to catch those responsible for mob lynching in Jharkhand, a BJP ruled state, will you go to Jharkhand and protest or not?
Rajdeep,
that is not under our jurisdiction.
Prime Minister has protested.
Prime
Minister of the country has said so.
Rajdeep.
We are irrelevant in here.
The Prime Minister
has said that the killers should be booked.
And we are talking about sedition. Sedition is something that is against the country.
So, what is the need for us to speak?
Rajdeep, yes. प्याज का भाव क्या है
ममता जी को पूछो ना
प्याज का भाव क्या है
ममता जी को पूछो क्या दिक्कत है
there are so many thousands of women who are anemic there are so many lakhs of kids who are malnutritioned there are 7 million disabled people in our country
okay
हाथे काट चाय पेटे भात चाय where is it
okay let me you know judge your court between angry voices
yes
I'm giving you 30 seconds Do you see a way in which this can end beyond scrapping it off the statute books? Because if sedition goes, as is being suggested, state oppression will continue. What's the solution?
Well,
what's the solution for our political leaders to stop state oppression?
I tell you, sedition is a form of state oppression. But if sedition goes, state oppression will not go. State oppression will continue in different forms. So in order to create state oppression, it is people's united resistance, that is what is important. A democratic movement, that is what is important. People should unite against such autocratic rulers. And when their turn comes at the hustings, they should exercise their power very wisely and with a lot of discretion. It is ultimately people's fight against such state oppression which is the answer.
Okay. The only regret, of course, we have is we don't have the Trinamool Congress there to respond to the various charges that have been made. But that's how it is. But I still appreciate that you've come, spoken out, and we've given everyone space and time for a dialogue. Obviously, when a dialogue takes place in Kolkata, the voices and tempers tend to rise. I never knew that Agni and Ratnaboli were such great friends till this evening. But it was wonderful
to hear friends speak. We are going to hug each other after this.
Believe me.
This is classic Bengali exceptionalism. You do everything differently to everyone else in the world. But thank you all very much for joining us. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.